Rangers, this is Daisy. Sounds like you're at the Little Vegas, judging by all that noise in the background. Remember, your first order of business is to find Delgado. Maybe somebody in there has seen him. While you're at it, if you can prove that Brago made a deal with the Dorseys, feel free to take that bastard down. Best of luck, Rangers. Daisy out.
Welcome to Little Vegas. We've got drinks, dancing, and games of chance. Pick your poison.
What's your favorite song?
Gotta be Sex Dwarf. It bops so hard.
Oh, yeah, that's a good one.
Stairs lead to Mr. Brago's lounge. He said I should let you guys through. But don't even think about messing with that computer behind me. I got one job, and that's guarding that computer. And if you was to mess with it, well, that would be a very bad day for you, my friend. A very bad day. Good, because that is the computer that controls the ventilation system. And I have to guard it because it's broken, and there could be real trouble if anybody said it wrong. You better not be, because if you were to set the fan to off and the heat to max, which isn't supposed to be possible, but right now it is, the furnace could catch fire and burn the whole place down. So I'm not leaving my post for anything. Well, maybe if a fight broke out I would. But nobody would be stupid enough to start a fight in Mr. Brago's place, would they? You're not gonna say I said any of this, are you?
Well, look what the cat dragged in.
Shit!
No more gambling for me. I learned my lesson.
Ugh, so gaudy. So ostentatious.
Rangers. Welcome to my club. Ah, Rangers, what a pleasure. I heard you were in town. It must be, what, 20 years since we crossed paths? Not that any of you would remember that, of course. You were probably just kids when Vargas and Angela Death and the rest helped me save Vegas. And I hear we have you to thank for Cassidy's fine clothiers being back in business. My capos and I thank you. If not for Cassidy's, we'd have to settle for second-rate suits from the bazaar. But I'm getting ahead of myself. I'm Farron Brago. Welcome to Little Vegas. My recreation of the glories of the town we lost. Perfect, isn't it? I'm glad you think so. You should have seen it 5 years ago. Nothing here but the walls, and half of them were falling down. We really worked hard to get where it is today. But enough about me. How are things with the Rangers? Is General Vargas still in charge? I'd love to give him my regards. We owe him and his team a lot. Is that so? Way to make a man feel old. But I'm sorry to hear Vargas is gone. He was a great man, ready to do anything to help the people he'd sworn to protect. Thank you for telling me. I'll raise a glass in his honor tonight. Now, what can I do for you? Certainly. Ask away. What? I don't want those kind of connections. Murder in the streets is bad for business. If I were you, I'd be looking for someone with a grudge against a patriarch. Not exactly a short list, I know, but... I know Delgado, but I haven't seen it. If he came here, he didn't come to see me. Good luck.
Fucking feet hurt.
Ugh, tell me about it. Killing me.
I am so tired of just standing here.
You know it. Sometimes, wish somebody to start something just for the variety.
Enjoy the party, but stay out of the rooms behind the bar.
Those two over there kind of make a cute couple.
Hey, where's Polly lately?
You didn't hear? He got promoted.
No shit. To what?
Boss sent him east, looking for franchise opportunities. Whatever that means.
Ah, it's you, Red Hats. I was wondering when you'd come to see Charlie Nose. Farron Brigo's capo, leader of men, hero of the Battle of Two Buttes, savior of St. Elmo, and friend to everyone worth knowing. Welcome to Little Vegas. Ah, a tactical masterstroke by yours truly. Imagine two round buttes with a narrow gorge between them. Got that picture in your mind? We lured our enemies into the gorge, then squeezed them from both sides, crushing them between the buttes. A real shitstorm, that's what it was.
I'm quite sure there was never a battle of two buttes, Mr. Nose. Sounds like a story you concocted while sitting in the outhouse.
Oh, you wouldn't say that if you'd been there. I'll never forget the groans, the plops of the fallen, the terrible smell. Sure thing, Red Hats. What can Charlie do for you? El Gato? What?
Come on, Charlie, you remember Delgado. Nice guy, family man, way too good for the trash in this place. No way you could miss him.
Oh, not like you, Marshall. You blend right in with the rest of us. Sorry, haven't seen him. Old Charlie would tell you if he had. You see this silver ram medal? You like it? It's my favorite badge. The patriarch himself gave it to me. Yes, sir, for saving his eldest son. Man, you should have seen the size of that snake. Till next time, Red Hats.
I love you, man. No, seriously.
God.
Welcome to the Little Vegas brothel, friends.
Hey, Quan. Looking for a good time, I assume?
Sorry, Ken. Me and my friends are here on business today. Rangers, meet Kendall, Colorado Springs' finest purveyor of sins of the flesh.
Delgado. You know, that name sounds really familiar, but remembering is going to be hard work. The kind of work a man should be paid to do.
Kendall, you predictable son of a bitch.
I need serious cash. Any less, and it isn't worth the risk. Thought you couldn't work tonight, Darlene. Oh, you again. What can Kendall... Shit! I knew I should have asked for more. All right. Don't tell anyone I told you. But Delgado was sniffing around the club, asking too many questions about the Dorseys. Last I saw, Charlie Knowles was pulling him into the back rooms behind the bar.
God damn it. Now Daisy's gonna want Brigo dead, and she won't take no for an answer.
He was sniffing around the club, asking too many questions about the Dorseys. Charlie Knowles dragged him into the back rooms behind the bar. He's probably still back there, unless they killed him. Yeah, okay. Bye.
Shit! Party!
Woo!
Hello again, Red Hats. Well, ain't you a clever seed of Red Hats? But let's not be rash here, yeah? The only way you're getting past that door is through a hail of bullets. And no one wants that. Look, it wasn't Mr. Brigo who conspired with the Dorseys. He's not that stupid. But a little bird told me it was someone in our organization. I can give you a name. All you gotta do is prove this guy was acting on his own. Way I see it, everybody wins. You get your culprit, and we don't get in trouble with the law. Once you clear Mr. Brigo's name, I'm sure he'll release Delgado. Look for our man McTavish at the machine shop near Pillory Square. I don't care what you do to him, but if you can come back and prove the rest of us weren't involved, I'm sure we can make a deal, yeah? Also, I didn't tell you this, Red Hats. Till next time, Red Hats.
Oh man, I love
you. Go away.
It's the best.
Issue with the Colorado Patriot?
Oh, real funny cartoon in there. And Jeffy ripped the robo arm off that scar collector.
I was gonna ask about the articles, but never mind.
Rangers hailed as heroes! Dorseys flee the city!
Oh, Troy. Yeah, always watching when I'm shopping and walking home. Do you ever hear of car gardens?
You mean where they grow these fine automobiles for our personal use?
Don't get cute.
Sorry.
I didn't know they existed until my pa told me to go down to this old man's farm. He said he had a few cars we could take. What we didn't expect was 50 VWs in his garden, hanging around like shrubbery in a rich man's home. Damn waste of some good cars, but...
So he runs out and starts trying to hose down the damn propane tank.
car's a lot like an old dog sometimes. If you won't learn new tricks, that doesn't mean you can't trick it.
Look, this time the marshal sent substitutes to shake us down. Well, you stand-ins get one warning. Fuck off or get fucked up. Yeah? Well, McTavish doesn't want to talk to you. And you just used up your one warning. Fuck 'em up, boys.
seconds. But I don't know what you're doing to me. Just leave me alone. Don't you know I'm under Farnbrego's protection? You can't touch me. Huh? No, I mean, if you shoot me, then he's gonna... Ah, what a load of shite. This ain't fair. Everybody shits on me, everybody. Okay, okay. Looks like you got me at a disadvantage, so let's make a deal, eh? You piss flaps drop me enough to skip tune, and I'll tell you what I can. God damn it to hell! I got too many holes in me already. Fine, I'll spill monkey desert trash. Okay, yeah, I let the Dorseys in the city, and I'm glad I did. Least I could do after the patriarch put me in the pillories. Asshole froze my bloody face off. I got a crater worm and no should be. Of course I wanted some revenge. Wouldn't you? The time? How'd you know that? Bloody hell, that's another thing the patriarch owes me for me. But, no, no way. Why would they think that? Mr. Bragg would not have done us nothing. What are you going to do with me? You whores! Didn't I tell you what you had to know? You fucking lawmen are all the same!
Copy, November 1. This is Ranger HQ. Go ahead. Copy that, Team November. Arrest team from HQ is en route.
Shit. That's not it.
Lick me. Bombag. Sod F. You wee. Cunts.
Come on, bile your heat, you jammy git. Hey, you've a face like a scalped hearse, you dobar. Aye, that'll do.
The last issue of the Colorado Patriot?
Oh, real funny cartoon in there. When Jeffy ripped the robo arm off that scar collector, I cracked up.
I was gonna ask.
Extra, extra, bloody shootout in Garden of the Gods!
Maybe I'll join the Marshals. I do like to fuck people up. Nope. Are you okay?
Oh, there, Red Hats. What's the rush, huh?
Why don't you tell your old pal Charlie what you found out from McTavish?
Well done, Red Hats. Thing is, maybe I made it sound like I could get you into the back, but I can't without Mr. Brigo's say-so. Go talk to him. Tell him what you found out, and I'm sure he'll be open to a deal. Don't mention me, though. Thanks. So, what'd you do to that poor bastard McTavish? Better there than in the stocks, I guess. I'm gonna head to the machine shop and clear up any mess you left, all right? Nothing but a favor between friends. You should go on upstairs and talk to Mr. Brigo. See you later, Red Hats.
I love you.
What? You stowed away on an Arapaho convoy? Oh my god, tell me everything.
I don't like to repeat myself, so get your crew together. Then we'll talk.
Rangers. I get the feeling this isn't a social call. I understand you had a little talk with McTavish, and I want you to know I'm as appalled as you are that he let the Dorseys into the city. He served me well, but, well, he's always been an idiot. Now, what do you want to talk to me about? Is that a threat? Are you suggesting some kind of deal? I'm not admitting I know anything about Delgado, but what did you have in mind? I like that. Keeps Daisy out of my business and takes care of a problem I didn't want in the first place. All right, you got a deal. You can take Delgado. I'll tell my crew to let you in the back. And I tell you what, because you've been so reasonable, I'll do you one more favor. A little bird told me you need to staff the armory at your HQ. Well, I just so happen to know a few guys who know about guns. Consider it staffed. What do you say? You're right. But I'm not the one who grabbed him. Charlie did. The idiot. After that, what was I going to do? Tell him no hard feelings and let him walk? Daisy would have been busting down my doors within the hour. So I just kept him on ice, hoping a solution would come along, and voila, it did. At least I hope it did. Depends on if you're going to accept my offer or not. So? Fantastic. Delgado's in the back. My crew will let you through. Go get him, and you'll have a fully staffed armory by the time you get back to your headquarters. Pleasure doing business with you, Rangers. Feels like old times.
You must die. I alone am best.
You're about to get drunk.
I have to go home.
It's just-
What's your problem?
This is for shooting! This is for fun! Who ordered the quick fuck? We can do it!
Be alive?
An Arapaho convoy?
Fuck me!
Oh my god, tell me everything.
It was dirty and cramped, and I pitched through a hole in a truck bed.
Smell that? They've been making chicken masala.
Hey, hands off the merchandise.
Like you too.
Hey, it's the good guys. Here's to you. Hey, it's the good guys. Here's to you.
Hey, Delgado. Bet you thought Daisy forgot all about you.
Quan, I figured anyone coming for me would have to shoot their way in. How'd you get past Brigo's crew? McTavish? That son of a bitch. Good. Good for you. You know, I had a feeling it was one of Brigo's people. Well, I guess I got too close to the truth. Right. Thanks again. Boy, gotta figure out how I'm going to tell my wife about this.
Easy now, Daisy. The Patriarch's invested a lot in these folks. You don't wanna...
Shut your hole, Quan. Don't make me ask you where you were when they shot Lipinski. might have been an idiot, but he was still a marshal. We're done here. I'll find some other way to take down your pal Brigo, and it won't include you. You know where to find the door.
You ever, shot anyone before?
No, just Wolverines around my pa's house. Oh, and a loony security robot one time.
I saw my ma put down a raider when I was little. On our way to Colorado Springs.
Rangers and marshals, will there be blood?
By order of the Patriarch.
My uncle, Gideon Reyes, wants to speak to the Rangers.
Oh, of course, Miss Wesson. Open it up, fellas.
Come in, Team November. Ranger HQ here. A squad of BAMFs rolled up to Ranger HQ. Rough mercenary types. Their leader goes by Gary Wolf. Claims to be an ex-Ranger. Says he has news for you about your old enemy. Seems like the cutthroat take no prisoner type. Over. That's a negative. Some hurt feelings and broken pottery, maybe. But they appear to be friendlies.
too soon to be back.
So they killed the Wessons, the Schulers, the Jacksons.
Maybe sit.
All the crime around here happens indoors. Someday I'm gonna live like this. Someday. Hey, boss.
Move along now. No trespassing.
Mount Everest ain't got shit on me. Mount Everest ain't got shit on me. 'Cause I'm on top of the world. I'm on top of the world. Yeah. Boys, Dubai ain't got shit on me. You can touch the sky, but you ain't got shit on me. 'Cause I'm on top of the world. I'm on top of the world.
At the door. Make perception roll. It's awful dark out here. Maybe we should go inside. This was your idea. You said it would be cool to play a game in the park. I got a 15. Do I hear anything? Do I hear a faint scream?
I burned down my house and built it up again. Burn it down twice just for the fun of it.
Did you hear that?
So much money I don't know what to do with it.
Where?
Don't pick up my phone and know what the time. I got me one gun and an alibi. So much love that the whole thing felt like a lie.
Don't need nobody. Don't need nobody. Nobody, don't need nobody. I don't need nobody. Don't need nobody.
Just save me.
Please.